of the important aspects of UFO drip chain coating is the application. One characteristic of UFO drip is its viscosity is dependent on temperature. At 75 degrees, which is mostly room temperature, it's very thin and transparent. At lower temperatures, it becomes thicker. This does not affect the performance of UFO drip chain coating. Today, we're going to take this brand new bottle of UFO drip, and this is at about 74 degrees in here. Take it off, you'll see that the factory seal is still on it. The easiest way to open up a bottle of UFO drip is to take the nozzle and simply pierce the factory seal. Might have a little bit of UFO drip on the top. Wipe it off. Do not remove the white foam factory seal. Just screw it back on. So I'm going to show you what UFO drip looks like at room temperature. As you can see, it's very thin, light viscosity, almost transparent. Now to show you the difference, this is a bottle of UFO drip and it's should be right about 64 degrees Fahrenheit. And this is about the coolest that we recommend applying UFO drip. Give it a quick shake. Now you'll notice the difference. This is 64 degrees Fahrenheit. And you know it's thicker, it's more opaque. However, whether it's thin like this or thicker, again, it does not affect the performance or the efficiency or friction of the UFO drip coating. Now I want to put this on a chain so you can see what it looks like when it goes on a chain at the cooler temperature. One thing that you'll notice is there are some solid particles that are on top of the chain, and this does not matter. It's the liquid that penetrates the chain, which is very important. The solid particles are dissolved in a hydrocarbon carrier, and when the liquid penetrates into the chain, the carrier is dry, leaving the solid particles. So again, if you have solid particles left resting on the chain after an application of the coating, that is okay.